What can you do with the particle? You can change its shape. You can put a few of them in a line, or in a plane, or in a 3D space. Make a shape, any mathematical shape. With enough number of them, display an image. Construct a model. Or maybe run your own simulation. But first, how do you even get a particle? Depending on the language that you speak to a graphic card, you can tell it to draw triangles, lines, or points. I'm using WebGL, so the word is gl.points in my language. But I don't speak directly to the GPU, because I'm shy, and also it's hard. So I use a library named thjs to make things easy for me. I define a location on my world, describe an appearance, and make a point. To have 10 of them, I simply define 10 random locations instead of one. Okay, but what can I really do with them? Well, anything I want. Let me put them on a line and use the sine value of the x for the y. When I add more particles and zoom out, you can see how particles put together carefully can form a meaningful shape. Speaking of shape, this is the parameterized equation of a circle. I plug my particles into this formula and draw a perfect circle. But nothing's perfect, and that's okay. Because out of this imperfection comes all sorts of patterns. And who said we need to create the shapes ourselves? Sometimes we have a sphere given to us and we want to produce it using particles. If we inspect this sphere, we can see that it consists of surfaces made of triangles, which themselves are made of lines intersecting each other on points called vertex. If we only show those points, we get what we wanted. Same goes for a model created with a 3D modeling software. I can render the model using particles, displace those particles, or morph them into another one. How about an image? If you think about it, each pixel could really be a particle with its own distinctive color and behavior, which when it's sitting next to other ones can form a complete picture. A 500 by 400 pixels image implies that I need 200,000 particles. I can animate these individual particles and put the now lively image on my website. 200,000 is a large number, but how about a million? Here is 1 million particles text, which I want to produce with 1 million particles. Showing particles at the place of the vertices won't just work out, because they lack the number and their position leaves wide gaps. I can use the surface of each letter instead and find random points on them. This way, I'll be able to populate as many particles as I wish. But now, when I move this amount of particles, the animation is no longer smooth. It's because my CPU goes through the particles to process them one by one on each frame, while my GPU is mostly idle with nothing to render. What if I could use my GPU itself to run all the calculations in parallel? The good news is that it's possible, and the technique is called GPGPU. The not so good news is that it's a bit tricky, just like guessing its full name. The output of a GPU program is the two-dimensional image projected on the screen. I can write instructions to tell the GPU to transform this projection and render a new image. But now, I don't know where my particles are on that image, and even if I spot them, there is no way for me to get the 3D coordinates from a 2D image. But what if, instead of the actual color of each pixel, I pass the particle's position as the color, and instead of displaying the image, I keep it for myself? Now, each color square represents a particle's position, saved as a color into an image. I can use the output of this GPU program in my other GPU program to retrieve the positions. Believe it or not, these colors are the coordinates of my particles. Change the colors and you have displaced my text. Now that my GPU always knows where all my particles are, I can finally render 1 million animated particles. Particles are not just fun to play with. They are also useful in simulating parts of our world. The embodied simulation is a classic example, where you watch how particles interact when they are under the influence of physical forces like gravity. I'm no scientist with a supercomputer, so I begin with three particles. When I apply the Newton's universal law of gravity, they soon start to attract each other. The final acceleration for each particle is the aggregation of all the forces upon that particle. So I have to check every particle against all other particles, which gives me the time complexity of big O of n squared. It's fine for 3 particles, but as I add more, the number of checks grows exponentially and I run into trouble. There are algorithms to reduce this pressure. Bonshot is a famous one. To use it, I start off with an empty square and add a particle. I add another one, but no 2 particles are allowed on the same square, so I subdivide the square into 4 quadrants. I add all the particles one by one and subdivide the nodes recursively until they only contain 0 or 1 particles. Now, if a group of particles are far enough from a particle, I don't need to check every single of them. I just use their center of mass to approximate their force. I have to create this quad tree and run the calculations on each frame. It may sound a lot, but actually it has a time complexity of big O of n log n, which is a lot faster than big O of n squared. With the help of the Bonshot algorithm, I went from 500 to 5000 particles. But can I go further? No matter what algorithm I use, as long as I'm running the calculations through the CPU, I'm bounded to process the particles one by one. GPU and its parallel processing nature would be perfect for the embodied problem. A particle already learned how to read its position from an image. It can also loop through that image to get the position of all other particles. Now all left to do is to calculate the force and save the velocity into another image. On each frame, the position moves itself by the velocity amount, and the velocity program uses the current position to decide its next value. This brute force algorithm means we are back at the time complexity of big O of n squared, but the GPU can handle it very well. This embodied simulation running smoothly is the result of the thousands of millions of operations being performed by the GPU per second. But enough with numbers now. I want to personalize this simulated world of mine. I'll start off with the shape of a single particle. It's a plain square by default, but it won't be anymore when I apply some math to squeeze it into a star. I'll color the star blue and adjust its temperature by the strength of the force it carries. The initial state of the stars is stationary, and when they move, they just charge into each other. I imagine they live on a circle that its center is the center of my world, and then add an initial velocity to nudge them along the tangent of that circle. They would have gone astray, but the forces between them hold them together on an orbital path. I'm happy with how they look and behave now. I put them in the space and place some stars in the background and sit back and watch. This is not the most extraordinary embodied simulation of all, nor the most accurate, but it's mine and it's special for that reason. You can create your own special simulation. Particle systems are used to make fire, cloud, smoke, water, sand, sparks, snow, and who knows what more. Plenty of ideas to venture on. And if you're wondering how did I make the intro animation, you can check the code I've put on GitHub. I've also uploaded the 1 million particles text separately, which you can try on your browser. Now, if you excuse me, I have a simulation to attend.